Centric 1616, 16 women to watch in 2016. We asked our 1616 honorees, how have you coped with racism and stereotyping in your industry?
When I think about racism and stereotyping, it takes me back to my childhood, growing up being called out of my name.
The moment someone hears Harlem's Fashion Row, there's like a perception that's already in their mind. They're thinking we're urban, or is the audience gonna be, you know, a little too hood for us?
Sometimes we'll go into meetings and there's certain looks on people's face where they're like, oh, I didn't realize you were black women.
I'm black, so it exists. We have dealt with this since we've been here.
I don't act like it doesn't exist. Racism does exist.
How I deal with it, I ignore it.
For me, it's been very important to speak up, not only when it's happening to me, but even when it's not.
We're more alike than we are different. And so when you walk into a room, the goal is to focus on how can we connect.
I've coped with racism and stereotyping by being very, very focused on the end game.
I almost feel like we have to go over and beyond so that people will know that you can put us beside any other brand in the entire fashion industry and we can at that level.
You have a problem because I'm black, that's on you.
My hope is that the individual will walk away not focusing on the color of my skin, not focusing on my gender, but that we connected in a way in which they never imagined.
I'm a big believer in be yourself and the world will adjust.
You can't ever tell me that I'm inferior and I will continue to defy your stereotypes.
I believe if I show my inner love, it kind of makes people think about the way they think about black women.
Centric 1616, 16 women to watch in 2016. For more Centric 1616, go to centrictv.com and pick up the March-April issue of Upscale magazine.